say glorious.
Glorious.
Shout it out and glorious. Make it loud and Jesus, we shout your name.
Jesus,
yeah, we thank your praise. Describe your greatness.
It's the power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger. The King of glory, the King above all kings.
Hallelujah. Who shakes the whole earth?
Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Yeah. This is amazing grace. The whole earth with holy thunder, who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder. The King of glory, the King above all kings.
Sing it again. Who shakes the whole earth?
Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder, who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder. The King of glory, the King above all kings.
Hallelujah.
This is amazing grace. This is amazing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. Yeah. You would lay down your life. Yeah.
Amazing grace.
praise I sing for all that you've done for me.
On earth as it blood is a rescue to the sin-stained life. Your blood is healing the hopeless and the broken. Your blood is enough. Oh, yeah. My Jesus is enough.
Your blood's a shelter.
Your blood is a shelter.
Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord, we exalt you. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, the presence of the Lord is here in such a powerful way this morning. There are miracles in the atmosphere, and they're about to manifest in a supernatural, in a mighty way. And I'm going to ask those of our pastors and deacons and those that assist us in prayer, I want you to make your way very quickly right now. I'm telling you that there is a powerful anointing of the Holy Ghost here today to meet you at the point of your need today. And whether you need a physical healing, whether you need God to do something in your family, whether you need to make a decision, whatever the case may be. Maybe you've been under great spiritual attack, but today there is power here today to destroy and to annihilate all the forces of darkness. So I want you to come right now. If you need physical healing, if you need God to do something in your family, if you need to make a decision, if you've been under spiritual attack, I want you to come and I want you to let one of these brothers and sisters agree with you in faith right now. Listen, don't hold back. I'm telling you, there's power here today that can cause your situation to turn around in Jesus' mighty name for the glory of God. Come on, let's declare that right now. His blood. Come on, His blood. Yes.
It's renewing, restoring.
Come on, envision that. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, 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 yes. Cry out right now. Cry out. Yes, 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 yes. More than enough today. And I want you to begin to plead the blood of Jesus over yourself right now. I want you to just begin to declare the blood of Jesus over you, covering you in Jesus' mighty name. And then begin to declare that blood over every member of your family right now. Declare it over your marriage. Declare it over your children in Jesus' mighty name. Father, in Jesus' name, we plead your blood over ourselves today, over our children, over our marriages today. Lord, in Jesus' mighty name, we declare right now that our families, Lord God, Lord, are abiding under the shadow of the Almighty. I declare in Jesus' name, devil, your plan is canceled in Jesus' mighty name. I declare you will not prevail. You will not succeed in Jesus' mighty name. I command you to loose your grip and to loose your hold. I say, let go in Jesus' mighty name. I declare God is turning things around. God's working things out for the glory of God. I loose an anointing upon you right now to walk in great power, great authority, great dominion in Jesus' name. If you've been under attack, just begin to tell the devil to get out in Jesus' mighty name. Come on, begin to tell him to go for the glory of God. Begin to declare victory in Jesus' mighty name today. Come on, everybody, declare that today. God's moving. God's manifesting. God's breaking forth in my behalf today for the glory of God in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Now listen to me. You may find yourself today in the midst of a heated battle. Maybe you feel like all hell has come against you today. But I got a word for you today that no weapon that is fashioned or formed against you is going to prosper in the name of the Lord. So you get your head up. You stand strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. And God is going to turn it around for the glory of God. Say, He's going to turn it around. Come on, say it like you mean it. He's going to turn it around for the glory of God. I want you to stretch your hands out towards our city. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, we pray for the city of Louisville today. Now, Lord, we thank you, Father God, that as we are assembled together right here, God, that as we call upon the name that is above every name, I want to thank you, Lord God, that you're moving mightily and powerfully, Lord, all over this city. I pray the Spirit of God would move up and down every street into every home, touching every family member. Today we bind spirits of darkness and evil and wickedness, spirits that have held people incarcerated and bound and imprisoned. And in the name and the authority of Jesus, I command you to loose your grip and loose your hold right now. In Jesus' name, I command blinders to be removed, hardened hearts to be softened, in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, I want to thank you right now. God, your Spirit is moving, Lord God. Lord, in epic proportion. Lord, we lift up the leadership of our city. We bless Greg Mayor Fisher. I pray that he would be the man you've called him to be. May his heart be open to you. May you give him wisdom in Jesus' name. I pray for those that serve on the council. Lord, I pray that you would just move in their lives. I speak the leadership of this nation in our city to be righteous, godly men and women for the glory of God. Lord, we bless this city today. We speak an open heaven in the name of the Lord. We declare the glory of God is moving in our city. Revival's breaking out in Jesus' mighty name. Multitudes are coming to the saving and redeeming knowledge of Christ in Jesus' name. Now lift your hands to the Lord. Father, in Jesus' name, I loose an anointing on every person here today. I loose a soul-winning anointing to be upon you, an anointing to be an ambassador and a witness for God. I declare there's an impartation upon you right now to bear much fruit in God's kingdom. I declare a boldness and a zeal to be upon you. God's given you words in season to those who are weary. He's given you the tongue of the learned. I declare he's going to give you divine encounters today and this week in Jesus' name. And you're going to be a great influence to God's kingdom for the glory of God in Jesus' mighty name. And everyone said, amen. Let's give the Lord a big praise clap. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, before we're seated, I want us to lift up Pastor Bob and Margaret and the team that's traveling into Israel today. And let's just pray that God would be with them for the glory of God. Father, in Jesus' name, we lift up Pastor Bob and Margaret, the team that's traveling into Israel. Lord, we pray that you would just protect them, you would keep them, you would preserve them. And Lord, I declare today, you're going to speak to them. You're going to loose angels that are going to come and minister to them. And Lord, this is going to be the most successful trip that they have ever had. Lord, I just bless them, Lord God, right now. And I thank you, Lord, your presence is upon them. And Lord, I declare today they're going to come back with a great report in Jesus' mighty name. And everyone said, amen. Amen. Won't you turn around, smile at someone real big. Tell them you're glad to see them this morning in the house of the Lord. You may be seated in God's presence. The ushers are coming at this time. And they're going to begin to pass out the communion here today. Praise the Lord. I'll tell you what, there is enough power here today, praise God, to destroy every work of the enemy for the glory of God. Amen. Hallelujah. The devil just doesn't have a chance in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I'm so glad I'm on the winning side. Hallelujah. Amen. And it's great to be able to come to the house of the Lord and celebrate God's presence and the victory that he has already acquired for you and I here today. Amen. You know, the Word of God tells us in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 3, and it says, blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has begotten us unto a living hope through the resurrection of the dead of the Lord Jesus Christ. And you know, that is a powerful, powerful statement in God's Word. It says, because Jesus triumphed over death, hell, and the grave, that speaks to you and I today that we as likewise can triumph over anything and everything the enemy may send our way for the glory of God. And it says that we have been gotten a living hope. Everybody say a living hope. We can live in continual and perpetual hope all the days of our life because of the victory that Christ Jesus has already acquired for us today. Amen? So there's no reason to be sad, discouraged, or dismayed, or perplexed. Amen? We're living in perpetual, continual hope because of what Jesus Christ has done for you and I here today. Today, you may be in a challenge. You may be in a difficult spot. But I want you to hang on in great confidence that God is with you and that God is going to bring you through for the glory of the Lord. Amen? You know, some people think of hope as just being wishful thinking. But you know, the biblical definition of hope is a constant expectation of an unseen reality. That's what hope is. Amen? I'm walking with a constant expectation, amen, of what God promised me to manifest in my life for the glory of God. You can't be sad. You can't be discouraged if you've got a constant expectation of a constant hope, an unseen reality in the Word of God. Amen? Because God's Word is the truth. You see, what you see is not the truth. Amen? It's a mirage. The Word is the truth today. And we hang on to that. And that's what our hope is in today. And so I want to encourage you today is to hang on and stand strong and trust and believe. Because what we hold in our hands here reminds us of what was accomplished for you and I so that we can walk in this victory for the glory of God. Amen. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you this morning for your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for the sacrifice that was provided for us. He that knew no sin, he became sin so we can become the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. And Lord, for that we are eternally grateful. And Lord, today we thank you that not only have you saved us and redeemed us, but you have covered us in your blood. You have given us, Lord, hope. Lord, that no matter what we encounter upon this earth, we know that we do not encounter it by ourselves. Because you said, lo, I am with you always, even unto the end. And so, Lord, we thank you for that today, that we're never isolated, abandoned, or forsaken. That you truly are the friend that sticks closer than a brother. And so we thank you today, Lord God. Lord, for that sacrifice that each and every one of us here today, and we express our gratitude in Jesus' name. Let's partake of the bread. And the cup. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, praise be unto God. I just thank you, Lord Jesus, for your goodness. Amen. If you would, take your communion cups, pass it to the end of the aisle. Our ushers will come and retrieve those. And if you would, direct your attentions to the screen as we bring up our ENN. God bless you.
Hey, I wanted to tell you about the best school ever. It has everything I want, like arts, sports, mission trips to places around the world, and more. And of course my parents like the great teachers and staff and the academic excellence they see there. But if you ask me, it's all about the experience. So if you're looking for a Christ-centered education for your child this fall, check out Evangel Christian School and see how Evangel School is developing leaders for tomorrow.
Evangel is leading a mission team on our third journey to Thailand. While there, we'll be working with Youth with a Mission to help rescue young people caught up in the sex trade. Over 300,000 underage children are working in this industry, and they desperately need the salvation message we offer. We'll be involved in prayer meetings, prayer walks, counseling sessions, street ministry, and we'll also be instructing Thai pastors at a seminar. The trip will be held June 24th through July 4th. Please contact Roger Hoagland at 413-0105 for more information. Evangel Young Adults are having an all-night scavenger hunt March 14th, starting at 9 p.m., starting at the venue 5400 Miners Lane. with all proceeds going to an upcoming missions trip to Belize. If you're not a part of the Young Adults Ministry here at Evangel, this is a great event to get started. Talk to Pastor Donnie for more information. SUM, Evangel's Christian College, is going on a missions trip to Mardi Gras this March. And if you're a senior in high school or anyone looking to attend SUM this fall, we encourage you to attend this missions trip. We have many students from around the U.S. attending the trip as just one of the many outreach opportunities offered by SUM. Call today as space is limited for this trip. And if you're interested in attending a fully accredited Christian college, call us today and see how SUM can be the answer you're looking for. Did you know you can give online anytime on our app or our website? You can even do it right now while you sit in church. Just go to our website, worldprayercenter.org. Click on Online Giving on the front page and fill in a few questions, and that's it. Giving at Evangel is easier than ever.
This Easter, experience King of Kings.
All condemned, feel no shame at the sound of your great name.
Let me see redemption win. Let me know the struggle ends, that you can mend a heart that's frail.
Part of this epic encounter. Sign up today and help change lives this Easter. For more information, visit kingofkingsshow.com.
Let's give a hand to the Lord. Let's welcome here. The presence of the Lord is here this morning. Come on, don't patty cake God. Give him a shout of praise. Father, we welcome you. We love you. We honor you. We adore you. You are the one we've come here for this morning, Lord God. Hallelujah. I want to let you know the presence of God is thick in this place. There was a group of people back here in the prayer chapel this morning when I got here at 8:30 already praying in the glory and the presence of the Lord. I hope you came here with your expector turned up to 11. Turn that thing up, rip the knob off. God is going to move in a powerful way this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, for being in this place this morning. I want to ask the ushers to come forward, if you would, please. At this point in the service, this is the thing I love to do. We have some very special and honored people we'd like to welcome this morning, and that's you. If you're here for the first time or the first time in a long time, you are our guests this morning. You're not visitors. Visitors are the people who knock on your door unexpectedly. You weren't expecting them to come, and they kind of surprised you. Maybe you're in her bathrobe or something. No, you folks are our guests. We've been expecting you. We've been preparing and laying the spiritual table for you this morning. We've been praying for you, and you're here. So we're so glad you're here. If this is your first time or your first time in a long time, if you would please raise your hand very boldly. Our ushers have a gift that they'd like to give to you. They're coming forth now. Our church wants to welcome you. Come on, let's give them a hand of praise, a hand of welcome. We're so glad you're here this morning. Inside that gift, inside that bag is a special gift, a book written by our senior pastor, Bob Rogers, that we want you to have. Let that be a blessing to your life. Also inside that bag is a card and a pen attached to it. The pen is yours to keep. If you'll take a moment right now and fill in the information that's asked for on that card, not only are we glad you're here, we'd like to follow up with you. We'd like a chance to get to know you a little bit and follow up. So if you'll fill in that contact information, one of our pastors will be contacting you within 24 hours to say hello, to welcome you, and to let you know how much we're glad you're here and see how we can serve you. We want to be here to serve you. Amen. Hallelujah. At this point, I'm going to ask our youth pastor. By the way, we have the greatest youth pastor in the United States of America. An amazing couple. I'm going to ask Pastor Matt Tidwell to come up, and he's got some special announcements to share about some new things that are happening here at Belltown with our youth. Pastor Matt.
Thank you, Paul. Doesn't Paul do a good job? He's awesome. We love Paul. Well, we've been in May. We'll be here for 3 years. My wife and I, Brittany, she's over there. She was just waved so everybody can see. She's beautiful, so I like pointing her out. We're excited. We know that there's a need here at the Belltown location. We know it's very hard for some of the young people to get to our youth services on Thursday nights over at the Minor Lane location. So if you are between the ages of 7th grade to a senior in high school, could you stand for me? Just take a stand real quick. 7th to senior in high school. Wave at me. Wave at me. Okay, there we are. There's our, some of our young people. We know that there's... Go ahead, take a seat. I just wanted to get an idea. We know there's 11 o'clock and a 1 o'clock as well. So what we have started is, last week we launched our first worship service for youth here at Billtown at 5 o'clock. And that service, just so the parents can be aware, before now, there hasn't been an area where they can come and maybe they don't want to come into the service, or maybe they don't have any place where they feel they can be plugged in. But if you come on Sunday nights, now we have a full worship experience for all young people, 7th through senior in high school, and it's going to be upstairs in room 201, right on the main foyer, up the stairs, turn a left, big open room there that we have a set and lights, and we're going to have media. But we have a full worship experience, worship, message, and we want to do that, and we're going to be sensitive to time. So we're going to do everything within conjunction of this service on Sunday nights, 5 to 6:30-ish. And then once we're done, we'll be down in the E-Bean Cafe. So we want to invite all you teenagers that are out there. And just so y'all can get an idea, we have some of our youth leaders here. So Greg, if you'll stand, and the Pulson Clan, Sinclair Clans, if y'all could stand, Clarissa, and just everybody, just take a look around. Y'all wave at everybody, let them know you're here. So if you're a young person and you're looking to get connected, and you say, well, I don't know anybody that's my age, and I don't know how I can get connected, well, you can come find one of us, and we'd love to share more about what we're doing. So thank you. Sorry I took so long. Paul, here you go.
Hallelujah. I want to encourage folks in the church to follow the venue on Facebook, on Twitter. Just go to the venue, look that up. They've got their own pages there, and you can really get connected with the information that's there as well. We've had a great week here at the church. There were well over 60 married couples that enjoyed an event that was put on by our church, a Valentine's banquet on Friday night, and that was a great job. I want to thank the Reeves family and the Jones family and the senior high youth who were involved in serving, and so many others who really poured their life last week into making that a special event for us. We also have a new opportunity for married couples focusing on strengthening our marriages. How many of you think that would be a good thing? Strengthening our marriages. We have a new opportunity here at Billtown, as well as our other Miners Lane campus, and Pastor Felicia's here to tell you a little bit about that. Pastor Felicia?
We have some classes coming up. They're called marriage enrichment classes held by Marriage Matters. And like he said, this Valentine's banquet we just had is a kickoff that we had for these classes. And how many of you got to come to that banquet on Friday night? So a good crowd here. It was a great time. And these classes are going to be even greater. How many of you know that love is not a feeling, but it's an action? It's something that we choose to do. And if we're choosing to do it, we have to act on it. And so we have to work at our marriages to make them work. We have to, in order to have that love in our marriage grow stronger, we have to work at those things. So no matter what stage in your marriage is, there's always room for growth. And that's what these marriage enrichment classes are. We're going to be talking about communication in your marriage. We're going to be talking about prayer and spiritual intimacy, finances, parenting, different subjects, raising children in 2014. How many of you know that raising children now is different than when we were raising children back in the 90s, back in the 80s? Today, we need a new plan. We need a new plan as parents, and we need to come into unity in those areas. So these classes are going to be greatly beneficial for your marriage, and I want to encourage you to come and be part of those. We do have a few changes. I know we wrote the times down in the bulletin, but we have a few changes. Wednesday night class will be here at Billtown Road, but the time will be at 7 o'clock on Wednesday nights. 7 o'clock here at Billtown Road. How many of you are planning on attending? Every married couple, raise your hand. Okay, Thursday night will be 6 o'clock at Miners Lane in the prayer chapel. Here we'll be at 109 up in the corner of the building. So we hope you guys can come out.
Thank you, Pastor Felicia. Hallelujah. One last thing I'll mention to you. As you may be aware, I'm the director of Champions of Honor, which is our focused ministry to men here at Evangel. And we have a new class that's offering right here at Billtown Road. We felt like Billtown might be a little underserved. There's a lot of men here who are not yet plugged in. Say Proverbs 27:17. See, that's my favorite verse. I learned from Pastor Bob Well. It says this. It says, as iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens another. And that's the whole spirit behind our Champions of Honor, our Focus Ministry men. We have a true champion who's going to be speaking to us this morning, and Pastor Billy Thompson. We're excited about what the Lord's going to do through you this morning. Amen. Absolutely. Give him a hand. And so Champions of Honor exists to serve the men in our church. We do life together. And so the new group that's going to be forming will be right here at Belltown Road on Wednesday evenings at 7 o'clock. One of our generations will begin meeting here. So if you'll come here Wednesdays at 7, men, looking forward to seeing you for that new group that's going to be starting here. At this point, let's give a big hand for another one of the champions of our house, Pastor Dave Keeling.
Praise the Lord. We always give the glory and honor to the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, we're going to go ahead this morning and receive our Sunday morning tithes and offerings. Let's give the Lord a big praise clap for that. Amen. Praise God. You know, some people think, well, this is just an interruption in the service. No, this is a continuation of our worship unto God. Amen. As we worship Him through our tithes and offering and the sowing of our seed. And we want to thank you for your faithfulness in giving and sowing into this ministry. And some of you may not even be aware or cognizant of the fact of the various and multitude of ministry that goes on right here at Evangel. I mean, we feed the hungry, we clothe the naked, we send missionaries out to the nations of the world. I mean, we are constantly reaching out, seeing the lost saved, amen, the hurting healed with the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And I'm excited to be a part of the ministry here that's reaching out in so many ways to advance the kingdom of God. And so I said all that to say this, you are sowing into good ground that is productive and bringing in a harvest to the kingdom of God. Amen. Amen. I think we ought to give God a big praise clap for all the great things He's doing. Amen. And you know what I want to also convey to you this morning? Is, you know, sometimes we come to service after service and there's opportunities that offerings are taken. And I think sometimes it can become kind of ritualistic, mechanical, and we really don't understand and comprehend the significance and the relevance of what we do. Because what we do right here, right now, affects our tomorrow. And I want to encourage you to take your giving very seriously. I know I do. I never just throw something in, but I give with an expectation of what God has promised me He would do when I bring my tithes and offerings into the storehouse. You know, just a couple of months ago, my wife and I were facing a very, very serious financial challenge. We had a rental property that we had had for many, many years, and we'd sold it to a gentleman, and come to find out, he just didn't do everything he was supposed to do. And it left us in a very, very bad situation, which could have been devastating to us. But I stood on that promise in Malachi 3:10. And I declared, Lord, I'm a tither. And Lord, you said you would rebuke the devourer for me and my family. And I'm going to tell you, it was difficult. It was a very hard position that we were in. And how many know sometimes fear tries to come in? Doubt and unbelief. And you want to get all nervous and upset. I know I'm not talking about any of you out there. I'm just telling you, you know me, myself. I'm not on your level. But some of that stuff was trying to come on me. But as I just begin to declare the promise of God, I'm telling you, a peace came over me and a confidence came over me. And God spoke to me, don't you worry about this. I'm going to honor my word in your life. And I want you to know God turned that whole thing around. And I'm going to tell you, instead of that being something detrimental, God turned it around so awesomely that it became a great blessing to our life. Amen. And so that's the goodness of God. And so today, I want to encourage you to position yourself in the blessed place by always honoring God in every area of your life, including your finances. Amen. And I'm going to be real honest with you this morning. During this winter months here today, like many of you, we've incurred an additional large amount of expenses here just due to the weather here at Evangel, the campuses that we have. And so today, I'm going to ask everyone today to do your best. And let's believe God together this morning to take us right over the top for the glory of God. Amen? Amen. I'm going to ask us all to stand. They're going to bring our faith confession up. Praise the Lord. And we're going to make this declaration. Now, I want you to prophesy that this morning. This is what's happening to you. Amen? Say, this is what's happening to me. That's right. Are you ready? Lord Jesus, I come into your house not empty-handed, but bringing my tithes and offerings according to Malachi 3:10. The windows of heaven are open to me. Blessings are being poured out that I cannot contain. The devourer's rebuked for my sake. This year is a continuation of the Jubilee blessing. By faith, I have a better job, promotions, raises, bonuses, and benefits. Business opportunities, sales, commission increases, inheritances, rebates, settlements, checks in the mail. I expect favor, interest, royalties, and scholarships, gifts, surprises, and newfound monies. I'm using wisdom and self-control in my spending. My bills are decreasing and my income is increasing. I have the anointing for blessings, equipping me to be a giver for the kingdom of God. All my needs are met and there is no lack. I have power to create wealth. The favor of God is upon me, and everything I put my hand to will prosper. I'm a cheerful giver, sowing into good ground that's bringing souls into the kingdom of God, and my God is supplying all my needs. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. How many are here this morning and you need a job? You need a job, you need a raise, you need a promotion, you need increase in your life? Well, God's going to release that to you for the glory of God. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you right now. Lord, for your blessings that maketh rich and addeth no sorrow to it. And Lord, I want to thank you that you're a God of your word. And Lord, this morning we take you at your word. And as we bring our tithes and offerings and the sowing of our seed, I thank you that that's setting in motion, Lord, a release of increase and abundance to flood and invade our life. I declare your people blessed in the name of the Lord. I loose God's favor upon you in Jesus' mighty name. I declare you're not going under, you're going over in the name of the Lord. And I prophesy an anointing upon you when everybody else is failing, you're going to succeed in the name of the Lord. I declare God is going to cause you to increase more and more, even you and your children, because you're blessed of God in Jesus' mighty name. And everyone said, amen. All right, God bless you as you give. Just a moment, we'll receive our Seed Faith March.
We're going to pause just for a moment. I promise we'll return you to the service here in just a matter of minutes. But I want to remind you that you can call for prayer. The number is on your screen, 888-613-6080. If you're unable to call, you can send it in by email to prayer@worldprayercenter.org. We're believing God to meet you and to meet the need of your life. We serve a God who answers prayer. And he said in his word that we should call on him. We should ask that we would receive, seek that we would find, knock, and the door would be open. So there's many reminders. Make your requests known unto God is another verse in the scripture. So we're asking you to join with us in agreement according to Matthew 18:19. And these partners will pray with you and believe God for your need to be met. So I encourage you to place that call and let's believe God to do something great and mighty in your life today. Now we're going to go back into the service. And we're going to believe God for something great. I want to encourage you to open your heart, get your Bible out so you can follow along with the preaching of the Word. And when prayer is lifted up, you join in that prayer. And again, if you need to call, give us a call, 888-613-6080. We're going to go back into the service now as it continues.
Who rules the nations? Who rules the nations?
Let's give the Lord a big praise clap. Amen. Amen. Pastor Ben, if you'd come over here and join me, and you may be seated in just a moment. And well, this morning is kind of a melancholy morning in some respect, because this is Pastor Ben's, his last Sunday morning service with us. And you know, even though we're sad about that, we're happy that God's opened up some great opportunities for him. And that he's going out what he feels is God's will, and we bless him. Amen. We're going to mess him, but we're going to bless him. Amen. And I want you to stretch your hands out towards him here today. You know, God has a great plan for their life, and he's going to use them, and we're going to be hearing much about him in the days ahead. Amen, of what God's doing. So let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, I bless Pastor Ben and Ursula and the family. And Lord, I pray today, God, as they embark upon the journey, Lord, that you have ordained for them, I just pray, God, that you would freshly anoint them, empower them. Lord, I pray you would give them revelation, and Lord, that you would use them, Lord, to advance your kingdom. We speak, Lord, provision and protection upon their life. Lord, may they be led and guided by your Spirit all their days, and may they always be in the right place at the right time, doing the right thing in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. We love you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. One other last item before I introduce our guest. Tim Todd, who was here last week, had this wonderful truth for the youth Bibles. And I know some of you here this morning ordered some more of those. We have those in the back. If you'll see one of our ushers after the service, they'll get you connected up with your order for these Bibles. Amen. Well, this morning, it is an honor to have someone who is really no stranger to us here, and definitely no stranger to our city of Louisville. He played on the 1986 national championship team, went on to have a wonderful professional career. But you know, more than that, God is using him mightily and powerfully to shake this nation and nations around the world. And we're so honored to have with us one of our dear friend and favorite preachers here today, Brother Billy Thompson. Let's give the Lord a big praise clap as he comes. I know God's given him a right now, on time word for us here this morning. Amen.
Praise God. Come on, put your hands together for Pastor Dave. What an awesome man he is. Amen. Come on. Come on, let's just stand to our feet for a moment and just give the Lord Jesus Christ some praise this morning. And come on, let's give him some awesome praise. Father, we bless you. We magnify you. Come on, we love you. We honor you. We worship you. Come on, just out of your mouths all over this place. Come on, lift up your voices. You're worthy, God. You're worthy, God. We bless you. We magnify you. We thank you. Come on. We're setting the atmosphere for a miracle. Come on. Father, we honor you. Fill this place with your presence. Fill this place, Father, with your Spirit. Father, fill this place with your glory, Father. Come on. We exalt you. We honor you. We thank you, Father, for the things that you've done. Father, we thank you for the things that you're doing. Father, we thank you for the things that you're about to do in our presence, in our midst, Father. Father, we thank you for the things that you're about to do in our families, Father. Even as we're here and family members are not here, we thank you for what you're doing right now where they are, Father. Oh, Father, we bless you this morning. We thank you, Father. We give you praise. Come on, how many has a loved one that you're praying for? Just wave your hands like this. Come on, right now, all over this place. Father, we're praying for our loved ones. Father, we're praying for those that we love, that you have placed in our hearts, Father, our family members. Father, we're praying right now that wherever they are, that you're ministering to them right now, salvation, that you're pulling on their hearts right now, Father, and you're calling them back to you, Father, right now. Father, we thank you that you're loving on them, Father, and your desire, Father, is that they would be saved, and you're pulling them back. Somebody say, God is pulling on them. God is pulling them back to himself. Come on, say, God is pulling them back to himself right now, this morning, in Jesus Christ's name. Somebody go ahead and give them praise. Give them a shout. Come on, all over this place. Go ahead, open your mouths. Go ahead, open your mouths. I know it's early. I know it's cold outside. Come on. But go ahead, can you give them a big shout in this place? Anybody love Jesus like I do? Hallelujah! Glory! Hallelujah! Glory! We bless you, Father. We bless you. We bless you. You know, I don't get enough praise. Amen. I don't get tired of worshiping God. I don't get tired of praising God. I believe that we are the generation that God has called and God has honored to be a part of this end time generation. Look to your neighbor and say, you are honored by God. Come on, tell someone else, you're honored by God to be a part of this end time generation. Amen. How many believe that? Hallelujah. Go ahead and take your seats. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I just want to say it's an honor to be here. I thank Pastor Bob, who's in Israel. You know, I lived in Israel for 3.5 years. After I got done playing basketball for the Miami Heat, God opened up doors for me to go over there and play, and not just play, but to be a witness unto the people. Amen. 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 And I was such a good witness, they wanted to throw me out of the country. Look to your neighbor and say, that's witnessing. And tell somebody else, that's witnessing. The Orthodox rabbis, Jews, they wanted to throw me out of the country, and God sent a messianic lawyer to come to my rescue. He came and began to show me what I needed to do and my rights, and we got on national TV, and that particular rabbi announced on national TV that he was sorry for wanting to throw me out of the country, and that has never happened. Amen. Whoever they wanted out of the country, they were out. But God. Somebody say, but God. But God. Amen. Come on, put your hands together. God can do it. If God wants you there, if God wants you in a place, he'll make sure that you stay there. Amen. So we just pray for Pastor Bob and the team that's over there in Israel. It's an important time now. God is really ministering to the Jewish people. There's a lot of darkness in Israel, and that radio station is just going to make a difference. How many know for such a time as this, God has put on Pastor Bob's heart and opened that door up? So that's pretty awesome. How many are excited about that? Whoa. Whoa. Who's excited about that? Somebody say, more souls, more souls. Amen. The devil is mad. Look to your neighbor and say, who cares? Amen. Because God is interested in souls. So that's why we're here this morning, so that we can be in the presence of the Lord. Amen. I'm going to get into my message in a minute. I just want to let you know I have some product out in the back. And if you'd like to take me home, I'm married, so you can't take me home. But you can take me home in a CD, DVD, amen? This one is seeking God with your whole heart. How many know the importance of spending time with God? Amen. Well, how many know the importance of when you're spending time with God is that you're there with God? You can be in one place with your body, but your spirit and your mind is somewhere else, amen? So that's why it's seeking God with your whole heart. We have a lot of people in the church, amen, on Sunday mornings, but they're not in Christ. Come on, somebody. Come on. Amen. So this is seeking God with your whole heart, everything in you, and as a result, the blessings that comes in return. This is greatness, and this is a message about what God has placed in you, and that's Himself. Look to somebody and say, God is in you, the hope of glory. Now, how many of you have been looking at some people, they said they've been calling themselves a Christian, and you've been just hoping, when is that glory going to show up? Look to your neighbor and say, yeah, I know somebody like that. Amen. Well, God wants that glory to come out. He came in the glory, and before He left, He said, the glory that I have, Father, I give unto them. How many have that glory on you right now? Amen. Well, pick that up on your way out. And this is my wife's CD. It's a song. It's called I Can Be Free. You Make Me Great. I Can Be Free. So pick that up. She's a great singer. Some of you have heard her. She's been here. She's a prophet. And if you can, go to her website, Eternal Change 555, Eternal Change 555, and you can pick up the word of the Lord, the prophetic word that she gave concerning 2014. It's a powerful word. You need to read it to just see what God is saying. I'm sure it's going to speak to your spirits concerning recovery to the righteous. The Bible talks about the end times and the righteous. Amen. God is going to keep us. I don't care what the economy looks like. Come on. I don't care what the naysayers say. God is going to keep all of the righteous. Look to your neighbor and say, I'm a righteous. God is keeping me. God is supplying my needs. Amen? Well, listen, if you have your Bibles, open them up to the book of Luke, chapter 5. Amen? Actually, yeah, let's start with John 21. Look at John 21. John 21, verse 3, it says, Simon Peter saith unto them, I go a fishing. And the disciples said unto him, we also will go with thee. So they went forth, and they entered into a ship immediately, and that night they caught nothing. But when the morning was come, Jesus stood on the shore, but the disciples knew not that it was Jesus. Verse 5, it says, then Jesus said unto them, children, have ye any meat? They answered him, no. And he said unto them, cast the nets on the right side of the ship, and ye shall find. They cast therefore, and now they were not able to draw it for the multitude of fishes. Jesus said unto them, bring of the fish which ye have now caught. Simon Peter went up and drew the net to the land, full of great fish, 153. And for all there were so many, yet was not the net broken. This is now the third time that Jesus showed himself unto his disciples, amen, since his resurrection. How many know that these were experienced fishermen? Amen. But there came a season when the things that they knew and the way they used to do things wasn't working anymore. Come on, somebody. You know, the world will say many things, and the world has a lot to say, but how many know all you need is one word from God? You see, one word from God will change your life. And they had everything down pat. They were professionals, and they knew what they were doing, but something had shifted, and what they did wasn't working anymore. Look to somebody and say, there's a shift in your life, and only Jesus knows it. You see, no matter how smart you are, no matter what education you have, there are things that take place in the spirit that Jesus knows has changed. Amen? See, they looked on their natural eyes, they looked on their natural understanding, but there was a season where, though they fished all night, that they were not going to bring in what they normally brought in. And here, with their own understanding, they said, we fished all night, we brought nothing in. Amen. And in Luke, which I mentioned earlier, 5, Peter gave the answer, Master, we've toiled all night. We've toiled all night. There was nothing out there. He's saying, look, we've toiled all night. We know what we're doing. We know about fishing. We've heard that. We know what we should be doing. We did everything that we should be doing, Master. And so, Master, why are you asking us to go out into the deep? Why are you asking us to cast our nets on the other side? We know already. We did the best. We did it. How many know that's a natural answer for a supernatural problem? How many know when you've done all that you can and you've done everything according to the book and it used to work but now it's not working, something has changed? Look to somebody and say, something has changed. Is there anything in your life that has changed? Is anything happening that where you normally have done something one way and now it's just not happening? Well, Jesus came and even in the face of Jesus, Peter kept on going, no, we tried. But Jesus said, listen, just go out a little deeper or cast your net to the right side of the boat. You see, Jesus has revelation. Jesus has understanding. Our moments move. Our blessings, amen, they are right in the moments. You see, if you're a believer, Jesus has your needs right where you are. You just have to receive it. You just have to see it. See, Jesus said, cast your nets on the right side of the boat. So here they are, casting just a few feet over on the left side of the boat, and there's nothing coming in. So Jesus says, just a few feet over, just cast on the right side. That's not much difference. You would think that if we're fishing on this side, just 10 feet or 15 feet, you know, fish, if they're here in this whole area. We should be catching. But Jesus said, no, just over here. Just 15 more feet. You see, we can be out of place from what God wants by just 10 to 15 feet. We can be that close to our miracle, to our breakthrough. You see, our miracles, our breakthroughs are right there. But we don't shift because we stay in the natural, what we understand. When if we would hear God by the Spirit, we would just move over one step. Come on, somebody. We would just grab that one word that Jesus said in faith, and then our miracle, our healing would pop forth. Come on, somebody. Because God is a God of supply. When does God supply? Somebody say now. Look to somebody and say, God supplies now. Say it like you mean it. God supplies now. Somebody say, God's going to supply this morning. Somebody say, now. You see, God is going to supply now because the Bible says, now faith is. Somebody say, now faith is. So after you believe, the moment that you believe in the now, then you're just waiting for it to manifest. Look to somebody and say, I don't believe that it's coming. I know it's coming. Oh, you didn't hear me. Look to somebody and say, I don't believe it's coming. Amen. You know, people tell them, I know it's coming. See, people say, hey, do you believe? You say, yes, I believe. And we say, yes, I believe. But when you believed, somebody say past tense. When you believed, when you heard the word, all you're doing now is expecting, you're waiting on it. You know it's coming. Look to somebody and say, I know it's coming because I believed. Anybody believed on something? Anybody believed on something in the past? Well, how many know it's coming? If you know it's coming, I want you to just shout in this place, I know it's coming. I know it's coming. I know my change is coming. I know my breakthrough is coming. Come on, I know my healing is coming because I believed. Somebody say, I believed. I believe my God. I believe that word he gave me. And I know it's coming. I know it's coming. Come on. You know the forecasters, the television, they can tell us that doom is coming and the market is about to crash and the dollar's about to crash and there's sicknesses and diseases that are coming that we have no idea of, we've never had before. But look at somebody and say, but my God said. Somebody say, but God said. It shall not come nigh my dwelling. I've never seen the righteous forsaken or a seed begging for bread. Is anyone righteous in this place this morning? Is there any righteous men and women of God in this place? Blood bought. Come on, anybody stand by the cross and believe that because of the cross, I live. And not only do I live, but I live with power. Power through the Son of God and by His Spirit. Oh, somebody give God praise. Come on, stand to your feet and give God some praise. Give Him some kingdom praise in this place. Shout, I believe, therefore I receive. Oh, I believe. See, God is telling us, just move over to the other side. Just step to the other side, and therefore you'll bring in your harvest. There's some people that need to be saved. There's some people that God has put in your path, and they need to be saved. And God is waiting for you to just step to the other side. Tell your neighbor, just move over to the other side. Tell them, just step to the other side. See, God is calling us to change our thinking. Change our thoughts. See, Jesus never had a mentality of I need to save, because he knew that Jesus was going to supply his need daily. Why else would Jesus, when the disciples asked him, please teach us how to pray, why would he say, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day. Father, give us this day. Our what? Give us when? When? This day. In the children of Israel in the wilderness, when did God supply their manna? Every day. See, God is not about savings. God is about investments. Come on. See, everything that God gives us, it has a purpose. It is never to be stagnant. God is always supplying in the now. God is always supplying in the now. And where is the now? The now is in the faith realm. For now is faith. So God is always supplying in the now. That's why you must have faith to have all of your needs met. When? Now. Look to your neighbor and say, now. God supplies in the now. The now is the faith realm. And wherever there is faith, there is this exchange from the heavenly realms to the natural realm. And the only way that you can have faith is know the word that God spoke. Somebody say, just one word from Jesus. That's why whenever you're in a predicament, you don't need to go to the psychologist. You don't need to go to those scholars. You just need to go to the Word of God. Look to somebody and say, the Word's enough. Oh, I don't hear you. Tell them the Word is enough. The Bible says everything that pertains to life and godliness is written herein. The problem is that we don't believe that anymore. We don't believe that it's just enough. We believe that we have to go over here. We have to depend on what we know. We have to depend on our experiences based off of what we did. When Jesus is standing there and saying, cast your nets on the other side. Look to somebody and say, go ahead and cast them on the other side. Come on, tell somebody. Luke 5 says, launch out in the deep. Deep. Tell somebody, launch out in the deep. Step out of the boat. Trust God for something new. Come on, somebody. God is telling some of you, it's time to step out of the boat. It's time for you to launch out into the deep. Amen. You see, when you begin to believe God, things begin to change in your life. How many need something to change in your life? Come on. Put your hands up. Come on. Listen, I'm preaching up here. I hope y'all hear me. Look to your neighbor and say, I need something to change. I need something to change in my finances. I need something to change in my prayer life. I need something to change in my giving. Come on, somebody. I need something to change in my business. How many have a business that you need to see something change? Well, what is God saying to you? What is that one word God is saying? Do the word and watch God do the miracle. Somebody give God praise. Hallelujah. Some of you are going to go home. Some of you are going to go home and you're going to move things around. You're going to change things up. You're going to do things differently. Why? Because God has been dealing with you about your praise. God has been dealing with you about your house. God has been dealing with you about moving and changing some things around. But you never really heard the message like this, that if I would just hear the word and do the word, then I'll see the change. Come on, somebody. The change is right there. It's just a few feet away. It's just on the other side. See, the other side can be looked at as the natural and the spiritual. See, when we stay in the natural and we walk in the natural and we hang out in the natural, we become comfortable. You know, you can get comfortable with being a Christian but never enter into the holy court. You see, the temple, the tabernacle, there's an outer court, an inner court, and a holy court. Come on, somebody. You can get in Jesus and be satisfied. My God, I'm blood bought. I'm going to heaven. But God is saying, while you're on earth, I need you to be like me. And the only way you can be like me, if you step to the other side. If you go deeper. Somebody say, I'm going deeper, I'm going deeper. Tell somebody, tell your neighbor, I'm going deeper, I'm going deeper, I'm going deeper. Oh, go ahead. See, don't look at me. Go ahead, tell her. Say, hey, I'm going deeper. I'm stepping out deeper. I'm going deeper. See, in the holies, there's the menorah and the showbread and the incense. That's a change from the natural on the outside of cleansing and sacrifice. And now you're going from the natural and you're crossing over into the spiritual. It's another dimension, but yet it's the dimension that God called us to live in. And to the world, we seem crazy. To the world, we seem peculiar. All of this faith stuff. How can that happen? How could that be? That could never be like that. That's impossible. Look to somebody and say, but that's how our God is. He's the God of impossibilities. Oh, come on, shout in this place. He's the God of impossibilities. And I want to say this morning. God has raised and God has saved a remnant just for this time. Just for such a time as this. Look to somebody and say, I'm a part of that remnant. I don't hear you. I want you to shout, I'm a part of that remnant. Oh, there you go. Say it again. I like that. Oh, he saved the remnant just for this time. A remnant that will shake the kingdom of hell. The remnant that will let the world know that our God is God and there is no other God. There's a remnant that is sitting inside of this church that says, I'm no longer moving with the systems of this world. I will move with the systems of my God. Come on, and his great son, Jesus Christ. There are people sitting in here that you can't wait to lay hands on a sick person. You can't wait to pray and see God move miraculously. Look to somebody and say, God has a remnant. And I'm in that remnant. The Bible says that we are called to be imitators of God. Jesus said, follow me. You see, when you follow Jesus, you become like Jesus. But when you break down the word in the Greek, it talks about following me. But Jesus is saying, really, be imitators. Be imitators of me. You see, some of us are cool just following Pastor Bob, following Perry Stone, following people, men and powerful men of God. Come on. We like following, but we don't imitate. Who's imitating? Are there any imitators of Jesus? Are you just following? Are you just following? Or are you imitating? Are you doing what he did? Are you saying what he's saying? Look to your neighbor and say, the world doesn't want any more imitators. The world doesn't want any more Jesuses. They don't want you walking around talking about, I can cast out devils. I can prophesy. No, they don't want to hear that because the devil doesn't want to hear that. See, the devil wants it where it's just Jesus. He's gone. He's caught up. Great. I don't need anyone to be like Jesus. How many know you're called to be like Jesus? But the only way that you can be like Jesus is if you listen to Jesus. If you hear that word and you follow it. Listen, I'm telling you, this is the hour. Any word that you believe with all of your heart, God said, just step out of it. You've been afraid. You've been fearful. What would they think? This is different. This is not my norm. Oh, they don't know me like that. I don't care if you just step out, if you just dare, if you faith God and step out, watch what God does and stop worrying about the people. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's a remnant that God is waiting to manifest, and they're manifesting in the earth. It's the manifestation of the sons of God. Those are the ones that are bold enough, faithful enough to step out of ordinary church. Look to somebody and say, I'm not ordinary. I'm like Jesus. You spend time in Jesus' presence, you become like Jesus. You see, look up here. You see, Jesus was with them and he said, cast your nets to the other side. When you obey, there is a breakthrough. There is a reward. But you have to hear the word and do it. Jesus said, pray in secret and I'll reward you openly, my Father. You see, when you go in and you hear what he has to say in secret, and when you come out of that and you do what he says in public, he will reward you. You see, Jesus did the words of his Father. He said, I only do what I see my Father do. So when Jesus is speaking, we must hear and be bold enough to go and do what he's telling us to do, because our breakthrough, our supply is in the doing of his word. Look to somebody and say, step over to the other side. Tell somebody else, I'm stepping over to the other side. Tell somebody else, I'm stepping over to the other side. I'm moving out. Come on, there's some things that God has called you to move out into, and it's time to move out. Look to somebody and say, I'm moving. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Tell three people, I'm moving now. I'm stepping out. Hallelujah. Listen, there are people watching us on television. I'm praying that you are getting this message and you understand that God is calling you to hear that word that he's already spoken, the words that he's speaking, and trust him and step out so that you can bring in that drought, that draught, that great harvest, the drought that you thought was not there, but it's been there the whole time. And God has just been waiting on you to just hear his word, because he's always spoken to you, because he never wants you to have nothing. He wants you to have more than enough. Somebody give God praise. He wants you to have more than enough. Why does he want us to have more than enough? Because we've been made in his image. And that's why in the secret place, we listen, we hear, and then we go out and we do, and he rewards us. It's a thing about relationship. Many of us are here because we have relationship. But true fellowship is spending time with someone. And that's when you begin to know someone. There are too many people in the church who have gotten familiar with Jesus Christ. Oh, you've been saved a while. He's done some things in your life. But that's good. Look to your neighbor and say, that's old manna. That's yesterday's manna. Go ahead and tell somebody, that's yesterday's manna. Come on, tell them God wants to do a new thing today. God wants to save somebody today through your life. Come on. God wants to supply in a way that you never thought today. Come on. Look to somebody and say, a new thing today. A new thing today. Tell somebody, a new thing today. See, God, when we hear, God will always supply. That's why he never told them to store up manna for the next day, or it would rot. Some of us, we get around and we just don't smell right. Come on, somebody. Come on, because they're holding on to yesterday's revelation. They're holding on to yesterday's manna. Look to somebody and shout, God wants to do something new today. People say, oh, all that new stuff, the word is the same and never changes, but there's revelation on your situation that changes every day. Come on, somebody. Come on, he had Elijah. He said, Elijah, go here, amen, and I'll have go by the river Cherub, and I'll have a raven feed you. That was that day. Look to somebody and say, that was that day. But then God came and said, listen, I have a widow woman. I want her to feed you next. Look to somebody and say, there's another time. Come on, there's a list of people that God has set in your life, and they're scattered all around you, but you just have to be in the right place. Come on, somebody. Elijah was kept because he was in the right place. I'm telling you this morning, God is wanting to have you in the right place. He wants you to know that he is your God by you being where he wants you to be for your supply. He will not keep it from you. All you have to do is hear the word of the Lord. Amen. Somebody say, I'm listening, I'm listening. What is a kingdom mindset? A kingdom mindset says no when people say no. When they tell you no, you can't do it. When they tell you no, you can't have it. When they say no, that's not going to happen, you have to say no, it's going to happen. I can have it. Because if God told you, you can have it. There are people that say no, and behind that no is a spirit. Come on, somebody. Come on. See, when God has something for you and you start seeing the devil come in telling you no and no, but God told you, you have to believe the word of God no matter what they say. If God said it, that settles it. It's going to happen. Look to somebody and say, it's going to happen. God said it. God said it. God said it. Come on, I don't hear you in this place. God said it. God said it. Oh, I'm telling you, listen, listen. I had a lady in my church. She's about 70 years old. She came back to me and said, oh boy, I moved into a new place. God is working through me. I'm praying with people and they're getting healed. Come on, somebody. God has changed me. I'm excited. Come on, somebody. 70 years old. Look to your neighbor and say, how old are you? God wants to use you some more. Tell him he's not done with you. Come on, how many elders do we have in this place? Stand up. Come on, you're in the 60s and above. Stand up. Come on. I want you to say, God is not done with me. Come on, shout it out. God's not done with me. I can't wait to see the next miracle. I can't wait to be a part of the next breakthrough. I can't wait to see somebody raised from the dead. Come on, I can't wait to see God use me to lead some young drug addict back to Jesus. Come on, somebody. I can't wait to see God bless me with $1 million so I can fund the ministry some more, so I can help this. Oh, come on. I can't wait. I'm excited. You guys excited? God woke you up this morning. He has a purpose for your life, and that purpose is to make sure the kingdom of God is known in the earth. Look to your neighbor and say, God is going to use me, and everybody's going to know it. Tell them, God's using me. God's using me now, 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 now. This is not the generation. You can take your seats. This is not the generation for the young. This is the generation for the believers. I don't care how old you are. Tell your neighbor, this is the generation for us. Kingdom mindset. Kingdom mindset says that if it came from heaven, it's for me. Because nothing comes from heaven without a word. Nothing crosses over without a word from the Lord. See, that's why the devil wants to shut your mouth. He doesn't want you speaking the words of God. Because he knows every time you speak in the words of God, you have just set into motion. Amen. You have just set into motion a plan that God has already set up for you to receive from heaven. That's why you're a Daniel. You don't give up once you prayed the first time. Because it's not just God. It's not just us. It's not just the word. They're spiritual forces. Come on, somebody. And they don't want you to get the word, because every time the word is answered, come on, you increase. The kingdom increases in the earth. The devil doesn't want that. And that's why he tries to shut you up. He tries to squeeze the life out of you so that you can't speak. He tries to steal your breath. But when you speak the word of God, God supplies your every need. Amen. A kingdom mindset is a mindset that is set. It cannot be moved from the word of God. No matter what comes, you will not move off of what God says. How many know we need some people like that today? We got a lot of wishy-washy Christians, man. Come on, they say one thing today and then they say something else. And you're like, well, I thought you said this and I thought you believed this. Well, you know, things happen. Things change. No. My word says that God changes not. My word says God changes not. How is it that you keep changing on me? You say one thing and then you come back and you say another thing. Come on. No, who's going to stand on the word of the Lord? Who's going to stand on their word? They said it, that settles it. I'm not moving unless God tells me differently. I'm telling you, integrity is lost in the church, but there's a remnant that loves God. And there's a remnant that because you love God, they're called the righteous, God is going to reward. God is rewarding the righteous in this hour. God is rewarding those who have stood, and like Job, you went through some stuff. There are some of you in this place here. You've been going through some things. You've been trusting God, and you've had some things taken. Come on, somebody. And God, you've been praying, God, where are you, like Job? But God has been waiting and watching to just see what was in you. That's why Moses was there 40 days on the mount. In fellowship, not just relationship with God, because God was just waiting to see what was in the hearts of the people. See, time will reveal who you really are. That's why with Job went through all of that. God was just, it was a test. He was just waiting to see what was in God and what Job was going to do, what was in Job and what he was going to do. But he already knew about Job. He knew. He said, Satan, Job, you can try him all you want, but I know he's faithful. Come on, somebody. I know he's going to pass the test. I know he's going to pass the test. There are many of you, you've been like Job. But I'm telling you, this is the hour where God is going to recompense you and restore you. Restoration is here in this hour. I want you to believe it with all of your heart. You keep fighting, you keep praying, you keep believing, you keep sowing, you keep giving. Listen, sowing is the way that God gives wealth back to you in the kingdom. Amen? That's why I said God doesn't have a savings program. God just has an investment program. Amen? Somebody give God praise. God gives us an opportunity to increase. And the increase is in your destiny. And maybe God doesn't tell us the process we have to go through to reach that destiny. But because he showed us the end, we can go through whatever comes. Joseph didn't know the process, but he knew his destiny. He believed the word of God, he believed the vision, and he reached his destiny. He was second in command in Egypt. No matter what he went through, he saw the end. What did God speak to you? Has God shown anybody anything in this place? Has God given you a word concerning something? I want you to stand all over this place as I end. Stand up. Has God given you a word? Has God shown anyone a vision? Tonight I'm going to come and I'm going to move in the gifts tonight at 5 and prophesy and lay hands and speak some things over some of you. Amen. Bring some of your family members and these relationships. A lot of relationships need to be restored. God's going to do that tonight. Amen. God is going to release some understanding concerning things that you're working with that hasn't been made clear to you. God's going to bring clarity to that. Amen. But if you've been sown some things, it hasn't manifested, I want you to know God is faithful. He's looking to see in the righteous, amongst the righteous, who will keep trusting him. And get in place, move to the other side. Start moving, start making changes, start getting into places where people believe God with you. Get in places of agreement. Amen. Put your hands up. Father, I bless your people. Father, I thank you that as they came out this morning, Father, to the house of God to celebrate, God, that they came in not just relationship, but in fellowship. And that they take this fellowship, Father, back to where they're going, Father. The rest of this day, Father, making a difference, Father, letting their light shine, Father, being fulfilled according to your word, Father, so that they can increase, Father, and that they can be a blessing. So that they can be a blessing. Somebody say, Father, I want to be a greater blessing. I want to be able to do more. I want to be able to give more. I want to expand in the workplace, in the church, and in my home. I want to expand for your glory. Use me, Father. Expand me. Here I am. Amen. Come on and put your hands together as Pastor Dave comes. Amen.
Amen. Let's give the Lord a big praise clap. Thank God for that word. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, you may be seated in God's presence. Ushers, if you would come at this time. If you need an offering envelope, if you'll raise your hand, our ushers will come and they'll serve you. And we want to have the opportunity here this morning to bless our guest that has come. And he's shared God's word with us. He's done his best. He's given his all. And now we have an opportunity to sow into the ministry that God has called him to. And if you have your check, if you'd like to make it payable to EWPC or Evangel, that would be fine. If you have a bank card, you would like to use an envelope, the ushers will come and place that in your hand as well, or for a cash gift. And I want you to know you're sowing into good ground. You know, Brother Billy came. He didn't come with any demands. He just came very humbly and just said, whatever God will do, I'm open to for that to happen. And you know what? I appreciate somebody that has such a gentle, willing spirit about him is that. And so I believe today that as we will give, I believe God will honor what we do today. And I just want to encourage everybody to do your best. And I believe if we all do our best, it'll be enough to take them right over the top for the glory of God in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. You know, God's word says, knowing whatsoever we make happen for others, he will make happen for us. And so when you make something happen for somebody else, that sets in motion for God to make something happen in your life for the glory of God. Amen. Are you ready to give? Praise the Lord. All right. If you're ready to give, I'm going to ask you to stand. Praise the Lord. And we're going to just pray over this. Praise God. All right. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord, for Brother Billy. And Lord, as he's come and he's shared this word, I pray that this word would penetrate into the hearts, Lord, of every person here today. And Lord, I pray that we would set in motion those principles that were declared to us today. Lord, that every person here would be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. And Lord, I pray that as this seed that is sown, God, I pray, God, that you would multiply it back many times over, back into the lives of those who sow it today in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. God bless you as you give. And again, I want to remind everyone that tonight, 5 p.m., as Brother Billy mentioned, he's going to be back here. And I want to encourage you, how many have some people that if you just mentioned U of L, you got their attention? National championship, I mean, now all of a sudden they're listening. They may not listen to anything else. But, you know, you can use those things as a hook. Praise God. So I want to encourage you, let them know Billy Thompson's going to be here tonight, 5 p.m. And I'm going to tell you, he's going to flow.